After all of these years, just old friends, through the laughter and tears, old friends. What a find, what a priceless treasure.
Happy 80th birthday, darling. I want to wish a happy birthday to the greatest man on earth. You are kind, honest, and thoughtful, and we really enjoy your mirth. It has been a joy to be married to the wonderful man you are. Of all the men I have ever met, you are the very best by far. I can hardly believe you are 80, for you are young and spry, I see. Just wait till you get my age. You won't be able to get on your knees. I'm so thankful that you are healthy. You walk so fast I can hardly keep up. It must be the coffee that you drink. I mean, when you can find your cup. It seems to always be hiding. I wonder where you put it last. It's a wonder you can drink it. It seems to get cold so fast. But I wouldn't trade you for anything. You mean the world to me. I will love you forever and a day. You are so precious to me. I'm glad that we are together to face the problems, great or small, for with Christ to guide us, we know He will take care of them all.
Dad, it's so hard to believe that it's your 80th birthday. You've always been so young, black wigged hair, and good looking. That means 80's not so bad after all, right? I know you've been keeping up with your busy pace, even when the going was tough, but for that, I honor you. I'd like to tell you that it's time to slow down, though. You can't run forever, and we want to keep you around a bit. I really think your motto should be that you see the glass as being half full rather than half empty. You have always tried to find the positives, even when the outcomes seemed bleak. You were the encourager. You were the peacemaker in every situation, no matter how dark it was. Rarely did we ever see you frustrated. Hurt? Yes. Frustrated with the sinful ways of the people around you? Yes. But never frustrated at them. And for that, I honor you. I value those early morning dates when we were kids. The times you took us to the donut shop all by ourselves. Some things never change. Dad, you still love donuts. Another happy memory was when you would come home from work and we would always be so excited to see you. We were so excited to have you home that we fought over unleashing those boots. Thinking back on that now, that's gross. All that dried meat on all those strings, and we fought to unleash it. Makes me laugh now. I always will treasure the vacation we took to North Carolina when I was 16 years old. Seeing you get so excited about your birthplace and showing us all around, then taking us to Ghost Mountain and riding all those rides, now that was fun. And thinking back on where you came from as a child and the difficulties you survived from your abusive father, I am so thankful that you chose to break the cycle. God was merciful to you and to our family by saving you at a young age. I can see that God had a special plan for your life and the lives of your offspring. If you look at your children now and to the families of those around you, I know you can see that you are blessed. Are we perfect? No. 1,000 times no. But we're sure trying to be Christ-like, and that's what matters. You've been a great father-in-law to your sons-in-law, as well as your daughters-in-law. They have loved you and respected you, and that's because it was easy to do. Did they always agree with you? Probably not. Did they always respect you? Probably. But that's because you earned the respect. You didn't demand it. Your grandkids adore you, every one of them. That's because you love them in return, and you show your love by caring for them. It's hard to believe that you're a great grandpa too. But then again, you are 80, you know. That's old. Your great grandkids love you so much. They love to come to your house. I don't think it's because you live near Dollywood or that you have a dog that likes to play ball, but hey, you never know. No, seriously, they all adore you. I know there are so many of your coworkers throughout the years that have enjoyed working with you, but the way you pick on them, it's no wonder. They love you or they wouldn't keep you around. Or maybe they would keep you around since you're the cleanup crew. Way back to your Farmer Jeff days, those people loved you. How could they help but love such a fine young man? You are easy to love. I have so many happy memories of my childhood, from the ready for a haircut, got any money, get out of my barbershop. Then there were the days of you helping me with my homework and me getting an F on my assignment. I still loved you even though I failed that assignment. But you will note, I don't remember you ever helping me again after that. You've been such an encouragement to me throughout the past 14 years of being alone. You've always been my steady arm to lean on. You were always there to listen when I needed to talk. I may not always say it, but sometimes I just need for someone to listen, and you're always that person. I know you've always been my prayer warrior. You mention my name to the Heavenly Father on a regular basis, and I always want to pattern my life after you. You are my hero. I love you very much, and I hope your birthday is extra, extra special. I love you.
Happy birthday, Grandpy! We miss you. We love you. You're the best.
Happy birthday, Grandpy. It's nice to see that you made it clear to the 80th. I hope I can do that someday. Anyway, just wanted to say we love you, and thanks for all the spiritual wisdom that you've given me over the years. It's been a great blessing and a help. So I hope you have a great and a wonderful birthday.
Jesus, name above all names, beautiful Savior, glorious Lord, Emmanuel, God is with us.
Happy birthday, Grandpy. I hope you have an amazing day that's full of a lot of surprises for you. I love you. Thanks for all the prayers you prayed for me and for our family. We can't thank you enough for those. And I've enjoyed getting to know you and just listening to your jokes and listening to your yodel. So I hope you have a really, really wonderful day. We love you. And Miss Michaela sends her birthday hugs and kisses to you too. Love you.
Hey Grandpy, just wanted to shoot you a quick message and let you know that we are thinking of you on your birthday and wishing you the very best one ever. You've been an amazing grandpa over the years, and it's meant a lot to me to know that you've always been there praying for me. And you wrote me a letter, I'm sure you remember that, you wrote me a letter several years ago, and I still remember that. I think I have it actually in my this little file with other letters I keep in it, and so many of the good memories that I share from you, everything from "Where's your preacher boy?" and the way you call the dog, and all of your little grampy isms and ways you say things, and your knowledge of meat cutting that is far beyond the average individual's, and just so many good memories. But most importantly, the spiritual impact that you've had on my life, and it's been much greater than you could ever know. So know that I love and appreciate you very much.
And I sure am grateful for the way you welcomed me into the family. I don't know if you remember that that night we were all out in downtown Gatlinburg getting donuts, and it was the first time I had met you, and you pulled me aside and just told me how glad you were that I was part of the family, and it meant so much to me. So, and you just started teasing me right off, which I love, and made me feel welcome.
As a mark, you know Grandpy loves you when he starts teasing you. So
we are very grateful.
Absolutely. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
want to start off by saying happy birthday to the very best dad in the whole world. I am so proud and so glad that God allowed me to be born in your home. We were all supposed to share a few memories of our past. It's kind of hard to even know where to begin because there are so many good memories. But I will have to say, one of my favorite memories is going down to the donut shop with you so early in the morning. I used to go to bed at night in hopes that I would sleep light, so that I would make sure that I was the first one up in the morning, and I would be quiet as a mouse so that no one else would go down with us, because I cherished and valued our time alone together. There were times also I remember you coming home from work and it'd be getting late at night, and you would make the announcement, "Who wants to go down and get ice cream?" And we'd all yell, "Me!" And you'd say, "Go get in your jammies." And we'd run and scramble into our jammies, and we'd pile into the station wagon and off down to the ice cream shop we'd go just to all get us an ice cream. Those were very, very valuable memories. I remember a time or two when I was so scared at night, being upstairs alone in my room after Cheryl got married, and I would hear all kinds of noises, and I didn't want to go upstairs alone at night. You would come up and stay in my room until I was sound asleep, and then you'd sneak down back to your room, and those were also times that just spoke volumes to me. Also the times where you always would allow us to even experiment and try things on our own, but we never were allowed to venture out and do worldly things. You kept an eye on us in that area, and I deeply appreciate that. Another thing is the fact that you always put us first before your church and before your work. You always said God was number one, and your wife and your children were number two, and the rest was last. That let us know that you put God first, Mom was basically second, and us kids were third. That left no doubt in our minds that you really honestly did care for us. You taught us always to put God first in everything too. You said that whenever we put our hand in God's and we trusted in Him fully, that He always would come on top. And that has been proven to be true many, many times over and over. I went through a very hard time in my life, going through a divorce and trying to raise four kids alone. But if it wasn't for you and Mom and the Lord, I don't know where I'd be today. Thanks for always being there. And thanks for always being a support. I appreciate that very much. I also remember times of you telling the stories of your past. Of Grandma, Grandpa, and the way you were raised, and the lifestyle you lived. And I look back at it and I think, you know, you've set an example of where you could have gone, where you came from, and where you did go, and how you put God first and how God has truly blessed your life. That was a good example for the kids and I. And I deeply appreciate that too. Another story is that you taught us how to eat a watermelon. You took it over to the picnic table, you gave it one good whack on the corner, it split open, and you started chewing. You said, "Now that, kids, is how to eat a watermelon." I just want you to know that we dearly love you, and we had you wrapped around our little fingers. We love you so much. I hope you had the best happy birthday ever. I love you.
Hey, Grampy, happy birthday. Hope you're enjoying this video that Danny was so sweet to make for you. She had asked each of us if we could make a short clip telling of some memories that we had of you, some things that we were very fond of. And it was very difficult trying to come up with only a few because I have so many memories of you, so many good memories, that I just tried to pull out just a couple of my favorite ones. Probably one of my biggest childhood memories is all the times that you used to take us to school and I'd be in the front seat and I'd be griping and complaining because I didn't want to be up that early and I'm not learning anything anyway, so why should I have to go? And I remember you telling me, "Hun, just calm down. This is all a part of growing up and it won't last forever." And I remember every time you would take us to school, we would stop by the gas station and we would each get a snack or a treat of some kind. And then we would take that with us, and that was our treat from you for lunch. And it was just kind of like a Grampy thing. Like, we knew if Grampy took us to school, we had a treat coming for lunch. And it was just something that is so precious and so sweet. Just you going out of your way in such a small way to say, I really love you and I care about you. Here's, you know, a donut for lunch. And it was very sweet, and I appreciated that. Something I won't forget. I remember other times you would tell us all a joke that wasn't funny. Like, even you said it wasn't funny. And then you would get everybody in the room to laugh by saying, that's what you call a preacher joke. It's not funny, but it's clean. And it just got me every time. It still does. Just cracks me up. Those are some things I remember from being younger. But as I've gotten older, my view of the things that are valuable about you have really changed. And I know that there are days that you don't feel like I value your opinion, or I don't want to hear what you have to say. And that's because you don't hesitate to tell me the truth or to tell me some bitter news about myself that maybe I didn't want to hear, or maybe I don't want that bit of information because I don't feel like I'm ready to hear the truth. But you never hold back. You always make sure that I have the truth. And that is something that I've really grown to appreciate and value about you, is that you've never backed down. You've always stood there and worked hard to mold me into the person that you felt I needed to be. You have had such a huge impact on my life. I can't even tell you what you have done for me. I honestly feel like if you hadn't been there for me when Mom and Dad were divorcing and growing up and dealing with a lot of emotional issues, if you hadn't been there to try to keep me stable, I don't know where I would be. And I really appreciate everything that you have ever done for me. And it means so much. And I love you so much. And I just wish so bad you lived closer. But like I told you, if you lived closer, I'd always be at your house. So I just want you to know that I love you so very much. And I hope you're having a wonderful birthday. And just thank you for everything, Grampy, for always being there, for always showing me that you cared, even in little ways, like just playing with me and just getting in the floor and roughing me up, or taking me down to the park, or walking me down to the ice cream parlor just to get, you know, an ice cream cone on a really hot day. It was just the little things that you took time out of your day to show me that I did matter. And I just want to thank you for always making me feel valuable and making me feel loved. And you mean everything to me.
Happy birthday to you. You live in a zoo. You look like a monkey. And you smell like one too.
Alright, so we're going to make this little video for you, and we're supposed to, like, say memories about you, but we have so many that we can't even put it all in one little video. So we had to condense it down to just a few, so I'm just going to start.
Okay, you inspired me to be a better artist. Like, when I would draw you pictures or color you something, you would always say, hey, hon, that's really great, and you said, I'm going to put this in my office. And that always made me feel so special, and I don't know, you always did. You never forgot, so it made me feel special. And I remember at, like, restaurants, you would always draw those little men in, like, 30 seconds, and I always thought you were the best artist, and I wanted to be just like you when I grew up.
I think one memory that stands out to me is, I used to be, like, petrified of storms, as you can remember. And you and I were on our way back from Wapak, and this really bad storm just, like, randomly happened. And I told you how scared I was, and I was like, Grampy, can you please pull over and just call Jesus and ask him to make it stop? So you immediately, like, pulled over on the side of the road, and you got your phone out, and you called Jesus, and you were like, she's really scared and like she really wants, you know, to feel safe, so just please come and just be with her. And you hung up, and then you looked at me and you're like, he's gonna be with you, you're fine, you're safe now. I just felt so much better that you called Jesus. It made me feel really special.
Always, you know, I'm sure you remember, I was always a sick child and I was always in the hospital for diabetes or asthma or peanut allergies, and I was scared quite a bit as a child, and I was always so comfortable when you were there, because I knew that when you prayed for me that, you know, great things would happen and he would protect me because you would pray for me, and that meant a lot to me, and that's just something that always stood out to me when I think about you.
One thing that's a funny memory about you that stands out to me, that's my stand, I just pops in my head, I think about you, is when you and I were baking one night because we wanted to surprise Grammy. So you and I were baking that cinnamon cake that Grammy makes, and it's just a yellow cake with cinnamon on top. And you were so proud of this cake, and when you got it out of the oven, it was so flat. Like, I don't even think it was an inch high, it was so flat. And Grammy's like, so did you remember all the ingredients? And come to find out, you forgot all the eggs. And it was so flat.
Okay, something that always sticks out to me when I think about you is your hugs. Every time, you'd always have a pen and some calling cards in your pocket, and you'd always, my head would always be about right where your pocket would be, and when you'd hug me, your pen would stab me in the throat, and you would squeeze me so tight that I couldn't hardly even say anything. But, and then your aftershave would smear my glasses, and I had a hard time getting it off. So I got to the point where every time you go to hug me, I'd just like, oh, wait a second, and I'd take off my glasses so you wouldn't smudge them. But I always loved your hugs, and I'm sure you remember that. I would always jump in your arms and give me a hug. One night, I was staying at your guys' house, and I don't remember why, but I was staying there overnight, and I was so scared to sleep in that big room by myself. And so, I think you guys had already gone to bed, and I came in, you know, little me, I just came over, just like knocked on the door, and I told you how scared I was. And so, you came in, and you slept at the edge of, you didn't sleep, but you just laid there, pretended you were asleep. And you laid there until I had fallen asleep, and then you went back to your room. But just knowing that you were there, and that I felt like nothing could harm me while you were just, you know, sitting there with me. One memory that I have of you, well, we all have of you really, it's almost kind of like a tradition. Every Thanksgiving, when the ham gets out of the oven, we'll like stand around and we'll watch you carve it, and we're just kind of like hanging around and we'll watch you and stuff, and you'll look back and you'll wink at us, and then you'll like go cut this little tiny piece, and while no one's looking, you'll make sure no one's looking, and then you'll like, you'll hand it to us, and we'll like sneak it, and then Grammy, I don't think ever knew until she turned around and caught you giving it to us one time, but that was always fun, still was fun actually. We have some quotes that, you know, we always remember you saying growing up, so we're just gonna say some of them. I remember you always saying, like, a lot. You'd always tell me, God has something and someone very special in mind for you, hun. And that, when I felt like, you know, my life was turning upside down and I could never find someone amazing like you, that was encouraging, knowing that you thought God has something very special in mind for me, so it was encouraging to me. One thing that's actually kind of funny is we'd always go to your house after church on Sunday nights and Wednesday nights, or any night of the week, really. And right before we left, you were always like, are you kids hungry? Do you want cheese puffs? Do you want donuts? Do you want bagels? Do you want a sandwich? And one thing that was always funny was, do you want orange slices? We have orange slices over there if you want some. So, like, it was never, like, really anything, like, leftovers. It was cheese puffs, donuts.
junk food. It's funny.
Oh, definitely one of my favorites would be 1, 2. What comes after 2? Whammo!
And you'd always like pat us on our rear ends and like, it was just so funny to us growing up, and I'm sure every grandchild remembers you saying that because it was your thing.
It was.
This isn't really a quote that you used to say, but one thing that made me feel good, and it was actually a very recent thing you said to me, was, I actually think it was in April. You called me, and I was going through a really, really hard time. I was going through a hard time. And you called me, and I think you had just barely found out what was going on. And you called me, and you just, like, the first thing you did was you prayed with me over the phone. And when you got done, you started telling me stories, and it related to what I was going through. And you just wanted to tell me how special you thought I was, and how you just, like, just in a sense, how you knew God had a plan for us. And I don't know, that was very comforting to me. Knowing that you were there and you called me. And even though you are, like, 4.5 hours away, it still was more comforting than anything at the moment. So I really appreciated that about you.
Something that I think about a lot, like when I'm with you, it's just every time you do this, it opens my eyes, and it's like something you always said just randomly. Actually, you never really said it, you just whispered it to yourself. But like, it seems like every time I'm with you, you would always whisper, "Oh, precious Jesus," or "Help us, Jesus." And I remember thinking, why does he say that? I always wondered why he said that, but just hearing you whisper to God was really, really calming. And it was very, I don't know, it was nice seeing you be so close to him. And that's what I wanted to be. I wanted to be close to him like you are. You are, like, by far, like, the best Christian example I think I could ever think of. Like, when I think of what kind of Christian I want to be, you're the first person that pops in my head. I'm like, I want to be like Grandpy. Grandpy's so strong and so close to God. And you're like the best spiritual role model. And, yeah. And you are the perfect example of selfless love. Because, like, you never put yourself first. It was always everybody else. And I don't know. Sometimes it's hard to be like that, but I don't know, I want to be just like you in that area because, yeah, I could definitely change and definitely, like, just instead of thinking about myself or getting myself ready for church before I got the kids ready, you know, even something like that, I don't know, because I know that you are, like I said, the perfect example of selfless love, and that's the way I want to be.
Hey, Grandpy. I just wanted to make a little video here and wish you a happy birthday. Sorry I'm not able to be there. You know, circumstances just didn't allow me to be. I want you to know that I really love you and I miss you very, very bad. And I want you to know that I appreciate everything that you've done for me. I appreciate you being that dad-like figure that I didn't have. I miss those times very badly when I could just run to Grammy and Grampy's, sit down at the dining room table, and just spill out what was going on. My problems, my dilemmas. It didn't matter what the situation was, no matter how insignificant it may have seemed, it was important to you because it was important to me. And I want you to know that impacted me in a very powerful way. Just knowing that I could come to you with anything. You never judged me. You never looked down on me. You always did your best to answer my questions, make me feel better about my situation. It didn't matter what the case was. I want you to know that I really, really miss those times. It was a transition whenever you guys moved to Tennessee. Wasn't able to just run 15 minutes down the road and just come see Grammy and Grampy. I miss those times. Once again, I'm sorry I wasn't able to be there for your birthday. I hope it's a great day. I know I won't be there, but, you know, I'm sure it'll be you know, pretty good anyway. Just want you to know that I love and I miss you. Happy birthday, Grampy.
Dad, I want to just take a moment and just talk to you. And I know this video is probably taking you by surprise a little bit from everyone. But I want you to know how much you have meant to me. This section of this video clip, I wanted this done in my office because I want you to know that most everything that I have learned as a pastor, I've learned from you. I looked at just some of the books that I have in here. Some of these books came from you. I look at my desire for visiting people in ministry and passion for ministry has come from you. And as you know, next year will mark 60 years that you've been walking with Christ. And your passion for serving God and reaching people goes far deeper and reaches more than I think you even realize personally. And I just want you to know that I hope you have an awesome birthday. And your impact on my life, there's not enough time to really describe to you how important it has been to me. I love the ministry, and I love the ministry largely because of what you have instilled in me. I think back to countless times of jumping in a pickup truck with you and going and visiting people and helping people, and just learning from you has been extremely valuable for me. And I just want you to know that I love you, and I hope you have a great birthday. And you have made a powerful, powerful impact on my life personally, and I just want to thank you for all the years and all the work. And as I look over my scope of a few short years of ministry that God has allowed me to minister, I remember some pretty dark days, and you were right there. Some fun times, exciting times, you were there as well. And your life and your ministry has been a hallmark of my life. And I thank you, thank you, thank you for it. And I just want you to know that I hope this birthday is exceptionally special. Thank you. I want to thank you for coming in today. And looking over the application here, I noticed three things that you left off. You've got your age, your height, and your name is not on here. Could you tell me what your age is?
Sure. Well, thank you for having me in for this interview today. My age is 50.
50? Oh, okay.
Yes,
all
I'm
right.
50.
And how tall are you?
5'2".
5'2". Okay. And what is your name?
Ginger.
Wow. Okay. Now, I kind of get maybe how you did the age and the height, but what was the thing with your name on your head? What was that about?
Well, to remember my name, I had to say, "Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, dear Ginger." My name's Ginger.
Oh, okay. Well, there you go.
Hey, Grampy, so we thought nothing better than to do a blonde joke for you, because we know that every time you talk to me almost, you do a blonde joke. So we thought that would be very appropriate. So we just want to wish you a happy 80th birthday. I thank you personally from the bottom of my heart for accepting me into the family and making me feel like just so wanted and so just so favorable to you. So anyway, we just want to say happy birthday, and we love you with all our hearts.
Love you. Have a great birthday.
Hello, Grandpy, and I wish you a happy birthday.
He left the splendor of heaven, knowing his destiny. 'Twas the lonely hill of Golgotha. Stars in the sky, and the sparrow can't fly. If that isn't love, then heaven's a myth. There's no feeling like this. If that isn't love. Even in death he remembered the thief hanging by his side. He spoke with...
Six years we've been married, it doesn't seem like it could be possible to have as many nuts as sprang from our family tree. They say like father's like son, and I guess that is so true. But when I see how crazy they act, they are acting just like you. But I wouldn't want it any other way. You are a wonderful husband to me, for you treat me with loving kindness for all the world to see. If every home was as happy as ours has proved to be, there would be no need for a divorce court, for Jesus made the difference, you see. I'm glad we chose to take God's way when we were young and free, for it sure has made a difference in what our children turned out to be. I know we've made some errors along some lines, it is true, but we are proud of our kids, for most of them turned out like you. I wouldn't want to trade you. You say you're like a Chrysler, for they have no trade-in value, but to me, you couldn't be nicer. So thank you for 46 years of being so sweet and so kind. When I think of what I could have married, it nearly boggles my mind. I'm glad God sent you to our church, for he knew I needed you to marry and take care of me all of life's journey through. This is a Valentine's Day letter that I'd written to him. Dear darling, I just want you to know how much I appreciate this new computer and my new van. You are so special to get them for me. I could never have gotten a better husband if I would have searched the whole world over. You are wonderful, and I love you more than you could imagine. I hope you have a wonderful Valentine's Day. You are a wonderful father, grandpa, husband, and pastor, the very best. And then I wrote a poem. If I had my life to live over, I'll tell you what I would do. I'd not hesitate one moment. I would love to marry you. You have made me very happy. No one else would ever do. For when you have the very best, there's perfect contentment too. I have always wanted quality above everything in life. I hope I met your expectations when you were looking for a wife. I know I had a lot to learn when I became your bride, but you didn't complain about my cooking. You encouraged me to try. You didn't know when you taught me to drive that one day I would chauffeur you, but that has proved to be a blessing. For now, I drive grandkids too. I love you very dearly, and I know you love me too. I want to be yours forever, all of life's journey through.
Oh, friends, after all of these years, just old friends, through the laughter and tears, oh, friends, what a find, what a priceless treasure. Been there, my old friend. Oh, we've had much more than our share. Oh.